Right, guys, principal here at Kanawha High School. And I'd like to begin tonight with this. For those that aren't familiar with our auditorium, I offer this information. There are five main exits. One is directly behind us, through which most of us enter, and you know where that leads. There are two exits on this side of the auditorium. Those lead directly outside to our front loop. The exits on this side of our auditorium lead to an interior hallway. So to access outside, you'll have to go either to the left or to the right. So as these guys know, we believe it's very, very important to be as comfortable as possible with your surroundings. Therefore, I share that information with you up front. So tonight, I welcome all of you to our spring band concert. Tonight you'll hear the work of our symphonic and concert band, both under the direction of Ms. Kim Mogus. I present them to you now.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us for a night of celebrating our last concert performance of the school year, our seniors' last performance at Kent Island High School, and the hard work of your children during the spring semester. It has been an absolute pleasure to work with all of the 86 musicians in concert band and symphonic band. Our students have a lot to be proud of this year. Many rehearsed and performed in chamber ensembles at the Music Showcase last week. They earned two excellent ratings at District Band Festival and the Music in the Parks Festival, and they were accepted to perform at Carnegie Hall in April 2019. Thank you to all of the administration, friends, family, colleagues for all of their support. This accomplishment this evening were truly earned with your guidance and support throughout this year. Tonight you will hear a variety of selections, all introduced by our musicians. I hope that you enjoy their performances this evening. Here to introduce the concert band is freshman alto saxophonist Jordan Hunter.
Good evening. You'll hear selections performed by the 27-member all-freshman concert band. Our first piece will be North Point Fantasy by James Swearingen. This piece features a very short legato section, but quickly changes to a more cheerful tone with the trumpets having the melody, which is afterwards handed off to the woodwinds. Throughout the entire piece, there are many times where the tempo speeds up and slows down, but it always returns to the same cheerful melody heard at the beginning of this piece. This song will also feature a flute solo featuring Ashland newcomer Lily DeShiel and Ali Arago. We all hope you enjoy this upbeat piece.
Thank you. The Dreamcatcher was composed to describe the American Indian hoop used in Indian folklore that suspends over someone sleeping to catch their bad dreams and let the good ones through. During our performance of the Dreamcatcher, you will hear a variety of unusual percussion effects performed by various wind players in the ensemble, with the entire band taking part. Be sure to listen for those effects, which include tapping and whistling. Our percussionists also have several different parts to cover, moves and rhythms they have rehearsed continuously to master for this performance. We hope you enjoy our last two selections for the evening.
Thank you.
For the past 3 years have been very fast. I am very proud of the senior musicians and who they have become, and I will miss them very dearly. Collectively, they have performed in all of the available ensembles here, including concert band, jazz band, pit orchestra, marching band, and they have all established a legacy of excellence for years to come. Join us in welcoming the Kent Island High School Symphonic Band seniors to the stage for their final concert. Gabrielle Calvert.
The syncopated rhythms that we perform all together make this one a real challenge. We hope you enjoy our first two selections.
Thank you. Treasure hoarding dragons. This piece, called Of Dark Lords and Ancient Kings, is full of intense dramatic moments that ease into slower, more ominous melodies that would make even Beowulf cry. We played this piece at festival in March, where the judges gave us an overall rating of 2. The tempo constantly changes from a steady 68 beats per measure to minute, 68 beats per minute, to a swift 132 beats per minute. The dynamics also shift from soft and mysterious to a loud and exuberant volume that is bound to keep you on the edge of your seat. The noble soloists in this piece are Gabby Calvert on the trumpet, Kylie DeVinson on the oboe, and Emily Lovelace on the clarinet. I hope you enjoy this ancient ode. The next piece, after that, opening night on Broadway, is a true musical classic, multiple classics, in fact. Arranged by Michael Brown, opening night on Broadway is a medley of iconic tunes from a series of popular musics that include The Producers, The Avenue Q theme, Always Look on the Bright Side of Life from Spamalot, For Good from Wicked, and, of course, who could forget, The Circle of Life from The Lion King. As each song flows smoothly into one another, you'll be snapping your fingers to the lively rhythms that have brought joy to those in theaters for over a decade across the nation. The stylistic changes and booming energy in this piece gives each song its own little twist, creating a dynamic piece that is sure to leave you wanting an encore. The soloists that make this piece even more fantastic are Kelsey Lilly on the flute and piccolo, Emily Lovelace on the clarinet, and Kylie DeVinson on the oboe.
Thank you.
Thank you all for coming out tonight to support our students and their musicianship they have developed this semester. Next Thursday, we will be celebrating everything that they have accomplished over the past year, and for some of them, celebrating the last 4 years in this program at our banquet next Thursday, May 17th at St. Christopher in Chester. All friends, family, students are welcome to attend, and we hope to see you there. I would also like to take a moment to thank the administration for their willingness to make our sometimes insane schedule and our goals work for our students. Thank you to my colleagues, especially Mr. Whitehair, Ms. Wright, Mr. Reagan, for their unwavering support through all things band. Thank you to the Band Booster Board, Bobby Combs, Jenny Wicker, and Don Wachowski, who worked tirelessly to organize fundraisers, our wardrobe, festivals, and so much more so our students can have an experience of a lifetime. And lastly, thank you to all of you, our student support systems, car rides to and from rehearsal, events, trips, and for being their biggest fans. Senior Zach Lambert will introduce our last piece of the evening, Into the Raging River.
You're too kind. Before we play the last song for you, I'm going to reflect on our last year in band. The year started with marching band, where the students performed Storms of Africa and received a silver rating. After that was phase one of jazz band, where we had the honor and privilege of playing at Safeway at 10 o'clock on a Friday morning. After that, the symphonic band performed our winter concert, and the pit band for the music man began. Pit band can only be described as a new adventure every day, with a couple of right notes sprinkled in here and there. After the music man, phase two of jazz band began, as well as the new audition-based jazz ensemble. After this, the symphonic band performed at District Band Festival, where we received an excellent rating. Next was Music in the Parks, where Ms. Mogensen embarrassed Nathan and myself in table tennis. The band also received an excellent rating, as well as the Spirit de Corps Award, which is given to the band who showed the best character through the day. Somewhere in there, we sold mattresses out of the gym. Last Wednesday, the jazz band, jazz ensemble, woodwind choir, and several solo and duet performances performed at the Music Showcase. And today is the spring concert, if you haven't heard. The band would like to thank the band boosters, parent volunteers, and most importantly, Ms. Mogensen for doing her job. The final piece for this evening is a tone poem called Into the Raging River by Steve Renick. This piece depicts a whitewater rafting trip, starting with the sunrise and progressing through the rest of the day. The group hits a few rocks in the middle of the song, but everything turns out all right by the end. The composer, Steve Renecki, currently arranges, conducts, and collaborates with the New York Pops Orchestra, Cincinnati Pops Orchestra, the National Symphony Orchestra, and most prestigiously, Kendrick Lamar. This song features a piccolo solo by Kelsey Lilly, a flute solo by Jennifer Donnelly, and a trumpet solo by Ryan Bachman. We also do some weird things in the song. This song also features the students blowing through their instruments, but not making sound, to emulate rainwater. And we use the bell on the vibraphone, which I didn't know was legal. So please sit back and relax and enjoy Into the Raging River. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.